I am Professor Jairam giving you some hotel law tips. Let us see what is hotel law. Hotel law is a bunch of several laws. It is not one law confined for hotel management. Several laws like contract law, food adulteration law, consumer protection law, and law of insurance applicable to hotel property as well as for employees. And also some labor laws. All these laws collectively named as hotel law. The law relating for hotel guest relationship is contract law. Contract law first developed in Rome in the book of Sir Henry Sumner Mine in his ancient law. He says, Roman jurisprudence of contract law developed in ancient days, later standardized in European countries. Now, in every country, contract law prevails. In India also, Indian Contract Act prevails. Now, what is contract? Contract is an agreement. Agreement enforceable by law according to Section 2H of Indian Contract Act. Agreement means a contract. Contract means an agreement enforceable by law. An agreement can be enforceable in the court of law if there is a dispute, provided if the agreement is legally valid. All agreements cannot be taken to court. Legally valid agreements only can be taken to court. The agreement to be valid according to Section 10 of the Contract Act, Indian Contract Act, there are some valid elements to be observed while making the agreement. Otherwise, agreement is said to have been illegal agreement, not legally valid agreement. Under hotel management and guest relationship, contract law or an agreement applicable. When a guest comes to hotel, tenders advance and books the room. Now these valid elements are, number one, offer and acceptance. Offer means a proposal made by one party to the another. For every agreement, there must be two parties. One party makes proposal, another party accepts that proposal. When two parties at the same moment, in the same state of mind, comes to the conclusion and signs the agreement or agreement comes into existence, that is called consensus addendum. hotel makes public offer. Under offer there are two offers. One is a private offer between two individuals, two parties. Another one is public offer, offer made at the public at large. The hotel is making public offer. Auto rickshaws are making public offer. Taxis are making public offer. When a guest comes to hotel, either to restaurant or to book the room, he accepts the public offer and it is implied contract, implied agreement. So, when offer is accepted unconditionally, the agreement comes into existence. Number two, there must be intention to create a legal relationship. What does it mean? Two parties, hotel management and the guest. When agreement comes into existence, the parties to the agreement are sure. If there is any dispute, they can prefer their appeal to the court for specific relief. The aggrieved party can go to court provided the agreement is a legal agreement. This intention of protection of law creates legal bindingness between the two parties. In a hotel management also, the management is under obligation to treat the guest. The guest is under the obligation to settle the bills. The next point is, next valid element is lawful object. Object refers to purpose of the agreement. When two parties makes an agreement, the purpose or object of the agreement must be legal. When a party makes agreement to rob the bank, it is illegal act. The object is illegal. When object is illegal, the whole agreement is illegal. So, the object of the agreement should be legal. When a guest comes to hotel, he must do some legal activities. He should not do illegal activities like selling brown sugar or any drugs. So, the object of the agreement must be legal. Next, lawful consideration. Consideration means mutual benefit. When a guest comes to hotel, he pays rent. Rent is the benefit of the management. He occupies the room, utilizes the room for legal purposes. That is the benefit for the guest. So consideration is mutual benefit. Under Contract Act, consideration refers to, at the desire of the promisor, promisee or any other person has done or abstained from doing, or is doing or abstaining from doing, or promises to do or abstaining from doing in future, such act or abstinence is called consideration. In hotel, the guest pays the rent, management receives the rent. This is mutual benefit. Consideration must be legal consideration, lawful consideration. When object is unlawful, consideration also becomes unlawful. Next is competency. Competency refers to competent persons to enter into an agreement. Agreement cannot be entered into a minor, a insane, insolvent, and privileged persons like governors, ministers. In hotel industry also, for minors, room or dealings cannot be done, room cannot be allotted. A minor is below 18 years. A person should be major above 18 years for any agreement. In other words, under Indian Majority Act, a person should be a major. Insane means mentally person not correct. Who is mentally incorrect? He is not a fit person for an agreement. And also, agreement cannot be made privileged persons like ministers, governors, prime ministers, because they represent the state. So, of course, hotel room can be booked by the governments or by authoritative persons when important VIPs visit hotel. For example, Barack Obama, when visited India, he was treated in the Taj Hotel. So, the agreement can be made only with the competent persons. It is also should be noted, a person who has drunk beyond the capacity and he doesn't know what he is doing under the influence of alcohol is also a not fit person to make an agreement. Next, the agreement should not be void. Any agreement, apart from the points what we have discussed now, by any other points, by other any other reasons, agreement should not be void, it must be valid. For example, agreement with the terrorist, or if the hotel management comes to know a person, feels some doubt on the guest, such agreement becomes void. So, by any reason, agreement should not be void, then it becomes illegal agreement. Next, certainty of performance. An agreement once started must be finished. It is also called a discharge of contract. Unless there is a breach of contract, agreement can be finished by discharging of the contract. That is, when promise on both sides, promise and obligation, when finished, agreement comes to an end. This is called certainty of performance. If the person is incapable of finishing the agreement, discharging the contract, for example, a guest is unable to pay his full hotel bills. He is unable to finish the contract. Their breach of contract exists. It is not performance of contract. There must be performance of contract, then only that agreement becomes valid agreement. Next is free consent. Consent refers for unconditional consent, acceptance by one party when another party makes offer. It should not be under any force. Consent should not be under any force, coercion. Indian Contract Act say the consent should be free consent, unconditional consent. Section 15 says it should not be under coercion. 16 says undue influence. 17 says fraud. 18 says misrepresentation. Coercion means the guest should not be forced to occupy the room. There should not be any undue influence. Undue influence is using authority. Husband may insist his wife, we will stay in this hotel only, even though she has no will to stay in the hotel. It is undue influence. Fraud, concealing the real fact, is fraud. By any fraud, fraudulent statement, guest should not be made to stay in that hotel, or agreement should not be made by fraudulent statement. Misrepresentation, real person is not coming in the front to the management of hotel or in the front office, some other person is appearing as a proxy person, what is called misrepresentation, which is also void for the valid agreement. So there must be free consent of both parties, free consent by the acceptor to the promisor or the offerer for the legal existence of agreement. Legal existence of agreement. The last one, the not against public policy. Any agreement should not disturb the public. It is called public etiquette. Example, a guest in the room puts TV or in high volume DJ, which disturbs the neighboring roommates, which is void, which agreement is against public policy. So under contract law, agreement should not be against public policy. Last one, legal procedure. The legal procedure for any agreement, when there is property dealings, the stamp papers are used. It must be remembered, agreement need not be in writing. Verbal agreements also are valid when there is physical act implied. Public offer generally does not require any written agreement. So, the legal procedure for hotel-guest relationship, when a guest comes to hotel, enters his details, shows his identity, tenders advance, the agreement between hotel management and the guest comes into existence.